Another day breaks and the last one's gone. You dig deep just to carry on. Your debt's paid off, but it don't feel gone. So you slip out.
So here we are. I'm getting ready to start the bridge, the actual lumber portion tomorrow of the bridge. You can see the steps right there, and the other step, they're 36 feet apart, and reinforced with rebar and mixed wire, over 5,000 pounds of concrete and mixed wire and rebar. So this is the steps I put in a couple weeks ago, about a week ago or so, and the wall built and the fire pit. So, so you can see there's some of the lumber we're going to be using over here. Got some pressure treated and some cedar. The pressure treated will go underneath for the structure and stuff, and hopefully it'll last for a long time, maybe 20 years or so. But, that's the wall I put up. And the fire pit put a few weeks ago. So here's the steps. And the way this configuration goes is that there's I made a step footings because it's going to be an arched bridge. So the ends of the trusses, or the foot end pieces of the trusses, all the stress goes down into the corner there, so it's not like the stress is laying on top, it's actually going down into it at an angle, so it needs to be reinforced that direction. So you need a lot of weight because it's a 36 foot bridge. It's going to be heavy, and you don't want any of this moving or shifting over time and causing any kind of problems. You can see over there, that's the mountain right there. I'm going to clear some of that stuff out and have a good view from the top of the bridge. But it's going over this little gully here, which is been putting rock down there. I got a whole bunch more. We excavated it out. It's supposed to look kind of like a dry riverbed, and I'm gonna put some mesh material over here to keep up the erosion and let some stuff grow. Put some rock in there too. So that's kind of what we got going on here. You can see once again it's a footing. The footing is in the shape of a step, and it's called Hell's Canyon. My wife named it that, and she stuck her dog's paw prints in there on July 10th. And we just had the house painted. I gotta stay in the deck and sand off the railing and stuff, but it's the back of the house and got it painted, and it's starting to come along. We got a lot of work to do. Still got the yard coming into shape, and Buddy's taking a dump. Sorry, that wasn't supposed to be part of the bridge film, but we got more rock up there and two-man rock. It's more gravel, so we're gonna make some pathways along down in here. So we still got a long way to go with this project, but it's getting there. So tomorrow it's gonna look a little different. Hopefully the morning of the big build. You can see the one footing over there, and there's the other footing. So it's gonna span across there. Hopefully it all turns out.
Anyway, here's the
lumber and stuff that we got for the bridge. We're setting up right now to get ready to start putting it together. Well, what we got here is used a template. This board here is a template now, and still cutting a bunch more to match it. What's that, Roger?
Attachment. How do you hold these together so the rock doesn't push them out? What is there something backing in there that's holding each one to the mat?
Yeah. Here's some of the cuts made for see, there's some grill off the wall there.
Are you okay, Margaret?
So we've been cutting some pieces here. Pieces over here, and we're putting some preservative treatment on it on the end parts for the pressure treated wood. Make sure it doesn't rot in those locations. But we're starting to get the assemblies together and coming along. Got most of them cut. Just need to put them together.
Got them, you gonna go on the
other pieces too? Mostly cut, and I think we're gonna try and assemble them on the sawhorses here.
Okay, we got.
But this is starting to take shape a little bit.
That looks right, Bill, because of the cutout.
This is the last assembling of the trusses. We got them all put together here. So now we just get that last one drilled up.
Take it the rest of the
we
way.
Can start putting them on the foundation. Keep doing the touch up for the treatment.
That side of it, I guess the line. Yeah, right on the line. All right.
If it's not exactly what you're tapping.
Yeah, we can tap it around. But you're just going to rest it in there and then we're going to tip it up. Give you the middle bill.
So here's another view of it. So this is where we're at. We got the two trusses down. And we got one more to go. What are you ready for? Oh, they got their hot dog sticks. You find any Pokemon out here?
Nope.
Dang it. Well, how's it going, fellas?
And a deer jumped.
Hey, Tony. He's taped.
Out of the ditch. And landed right on the
ground. See, I'm going to clear out a couple more trees here, but that's Mount Rainier on the background. But this is a... So what happened is we had the second truss was a little bit... We put it up there. It was a little taller than the other one, a little higher. So we ended up having to trim the ends of the truss at the foot on both sides, like a half of an inch to drop it down, and now it's level and plumb and flush. So it's coming along. It's coming together.
No, go right on the end bolt. Yeah, go right on the very end. Yeah. All right. Okay.
These are some of the steps I made the other day, or actually, had a week. But, so, here's the bridge, and so we just came up with some old blocks that we had for a landing pad, and put them down, leveled it down, compacted it with the tamper, hand tamper, and so this is what the three trusses look like. Got Bill over here. He's trying to get the front pieces cut, the wedges. It's kind of being a stinker, but this is how it this is how it's going. And these guys are digging for the other side of the block for the landing pad on the side. How's it going, guys?
Good. Good, we're big digging a trench.
All right. So, anyway, that's the progress. So, last time I checked in, I don't think we only had like one or two, but now we got the three trusses up. And it's going along. It's taking a while. Hey, Roger.
Hi.
But you can see what it looks like up and down.
Anyway, show you.
This is kind of where I left off on the bridge. Probably not going to get much more done. So, until a few days, because this weekend we got cheer camp coming over for a camp out and stuff. So they'll be taking up all the time this Saturday, this weekend, so hopefully I can get a little bit done Sunday and in the middle of next week. But this is kind of where we're at right now. You can see the structure. I already showed this. We laid some blocks for the ramp. It's going to come down off of here, off of this cross member here. It'll hook on there and be bolted through. And there'll be three legs coming down under that. Got it tied off to a stump. Got it plumbed, but probably have to re-plumb it again before I lay the decking down. Hopefully start getting the deck boards down Sunday and finish it up sometime this week. Next week, I should say. But this is kind of what you're looking at. Let's see how the joints fit together. Kind of just get cut into a nice snug fit, which locks them into place. And these bolts, basically they're not for structural support. All they are is just to hold the stuff together until you can get it put together and assembled. And the footings, I think I told you, I'll put some pictures on there of what I did as far as the concrete and the rebar and the mesh wire. But this here, some dirt down here is my fill. It's going to be filled with more river rock. So it's going to be full of river rock all the way up and stuff. And I'm going to have it's called jute. It's a jute fabric. It's like a mesh netting that I'm putting there, and I'll put these 12-inch clips in there, galvanized clips, which will secure it to this little funnel area to help keep erosion down. But until then, I started working more on my fire pit. I'm gonna lay some brick around it and some gravel. So hopefully I'll be able to get some two-man rock down here for along the inside of this area, which will be gravel and lined by these pavers. But about two-man rock up on the hill up there, and you can't see it, but they're up there. I'm just trying to figure out how I'm going to get them down without having to rent another excavator and keep hauling them down here and chewing up my lawn. But so that's pretty much where we're at right now. So,
okay. All right. So anyway,
next
we had a big cheer camp out this weekend, so didn't get a lot done. Had people over here and they camped out. And so what we did do is we got these the approach ramps installed and put up, set up. So and we got those cut. We got the rest of the boards furred, and we added some cross straps in one section. I got to finish that up today for shear strength. CR16, and put some brackets on some of these furred joints where you had to make the cut, the fur cut, to fur it in there to so your decking boards can sit on top of it. Nail those in. So what I plan on doing today is finishing up the strapping on it. This is the other side where the approach ramp comes in from this side. So I plan on finishing the shear strap on top here today, and then start cutting the decking boards. Hopefully get some of those installed today. But this is how it's coming along. And I know this isn't a actual minute process by process approach video I'm showing you, but it gives you an idea of how things look and how they go together. So
from this vantage point, you can see that I just finished putting the straps on here for cross shear support. And there goes my dog. Anyway, so I ran these straps across for cross shear support, and it already made a big difference. When I grab the bridge and shake it back and forth and stuff, it's a lot more steady. So by the time that I I'm getting ready to cut the deck boards right now, so by the time I get those on, it'll even be more secure. So
okay,
that's so where I'm at now. I got 10-foot 2x6s. They're actually 10 foot and a quarter inch, so I've been cutting them at 5 1/8, and these are so the span is actually just a little less than 5 feet. So when I'm done laying all the decking, come back in and trim the edge off a little bit and straighten it up. So that's kind of where I'm at right now. You see the... It's coming along.
So as you can see, I started putting on some of the decking board just now. Well, a little while ago. Started cutting some boards up and laying them down. So I'm going to walk down there and get a quick look.
Here I am. I started laying down the deck boards. And this is the progress I've made. You can see it's coming along using 3-inch exterior screws. Screw them down. I'm just using a regular carpenter's pencil for the width of the, let's see, between the boards. Plans actually call out for probably 1 inch, it says, but it doesn't matter, it's up to you. These are loose boards here. So this is what's going on here, and I'm trying to put it together. It's coming along. Progress. So I'm not sure the last time I did some filming, but anyway, so made a little bit of progress. We got some more deck boards screwed down, and it's almost to the other side, the same amount on the other side. So right here, and trying to get it to where it matches up good at the ends, and hopefully the lumber account is accurate. But so this is where we're at. I know there's not a lot of detailed information, but I'm just trying to give you an overview. If you're interested in a bridge like this,
I actually got the plans for it from a nice fella on the internet whose name is Michael, but his dad's name was Frank, and he's one who designed these bridges. It's called the Rainbow Bridge. I don't know if it's a Rainbow Bridge Company or Rainbow Bridges, but anyway, if you look it up, Rainbow Bridges online, I'll put a link on there too. You can get you can order yourself a custom sized plan for whatever length of bridge you're interested in, up to 50 feet, I think it is. But so here, I'm gonna continue on.
The deck boards are on,
and like I said, gonna start working on the handrails today. Process is moving a few rocks down here too. You can see. But so here is the deck boards. I used a carpenter's pencil width to keep them apart for distance in between the boards. Not the flat side, but the edge on. So it's a little wider, about a half inch, a little more. Some of them I went 3/4 inch to try and make it so it matches up on some of the peaks in the edge of the ramp. So anywhere from a half inch to 3/4 inch. The plans the guy gave me said, you know, he recommends about an inch, but that's that can be changed however your preference is. So anyway, I'll walk across it for you. Let's see. Chance to look down. Look back. Look around. See the mountain. And this is all going to be filled in with more river rock. Those are just there to support keep it plumb until finished. That's about that. So anyway, the deck boards are all completed and put on, and I'm getting ready to start the handrails today. So hopefully that works out good. I'll go down there and give you a closer look. Oh, we're gonna finish putting the railings on today on the bridge. Let's see. Got the side posts just tied into the existing carriage bolts. They're in the structure itself. So just lined it up, tapped it with the hammer to make a mark for the hole drilling, and I drilled a hole and put a carriage bolt in it and getting ready to finish it up today. It's gonna be a hot day. See the mountain. Okay, the bridge is finished now, except for the couple more screws I gotta put in and some stain. I'm gonna seal it, but the guys did a fine job. And we're going to have a ribbon cutting ceremony here.
Ceremonies. I got to give Uncle Bill these scissors.
We're doing a ribbon cutting ceremony. So Jaden from Iowa is going to cut the ribbon to christen the bridge. Ready? Here it goes.
Go down underneath and look at him. There you go.
Yeah. All right, go ahead and cut it.
Wait, he's supposed to cut it from the other side.
Okay, wait, come back. Come back.
Oh, yeah, all right.
There you go, I've seen you.
All right.
Now cut it that way.
Depends on who's taking the picture. Yeah.
There it is. Yay, let's hear the clapping. A lot of help here.
Here.
including the dogs.
I'm gonna go over here.
It's another perspective of the bridge. Give you an idea of where it's at relative to its location. It's geography. The fire pit's down there, you can't really see it because it's behind the bushes and stuff, but yeah, it goes around. But yeah. It'll look better once it's sealed. Stained. Not stained, it's sealed. Clear seal. Well, got the handrails done yesterday for the bridge. So it's pretty much completed except for some minor tweaks and adjustments and weatherproof sealing and stuff. So we'll take
this
a look at
what it looks like.
The completed project, almost. It's not really completed. We decided to turn these support posts on the side instead of flat on. One out of structural integrity, the other out of necessity because didn't have a saw that could cut through the whole thing on that angle. So it's almost done. I still got to run some more screws and some of the pickets on the far side over here. As you see, there's no screws and just some finishing nails. So I got to run some screws there, and it will be pretty much done. I mean, except for cleaning it off and sealing it and taking off a couple of these boards that we use just to keep a plumb. But I'll take you across it and take a little walk. It's really sturdy and stable since I put the screw of the 16 gauge strap in between the deck boards underneath the bridge for shear support. It doesn't really move side to side hardly, so it's really, really strong. Feels good under your feet. And this is the top of it. And, you can see that this is the beginning of the river, dry river bed. I got some oversized river rock I'm gonna put down in here and finish this up and continue the trail on down through here. And it's gonna loop back around also down over here, gravel path to the fire pit area, and also around the hillside and back up around that direction, which has nothing to do with the bridge, but just in case you're wondering what the hell I'm doing. So walk down here and I'll show you underneath the bridge what I'm talking about as far as the strapping goes. I think I might have shown you that already, but might give you a better view. So here's and you have these carriage bolts that they're not really for structural support. They're more for just keeping stuff lined up. So this is what I was talking about, these metal straps under the bridge. And I ran some little 1¼-inch screws into it, exterior screws. And once I put those in there, besides having it tied off to the trusses up here, once I put those in, it really secured it from moving side to side. So it made a big difference. Get my feet dirty again. But yeah. So I know it's not super detailed in instructions on how to put it together, but it gives you an idea. And like I said, once again, I'll give you more information on the website you can go to that I went to get information for building this, which is it's like Mathematica. Called Mathematica Rainbow Bridges, and seems like a nice fella. He sent me the plans for really, really a steal, and I'll give you that information. But yeah, I've seen some other bridges that they had designed online for arched bridges,
and they look really good. And I'm happy the way it turned out. So I would recommend, if you're interested, to support those guys, because the guy did some thinking for sure. All right, I'm getting ready to. All right, I just finished today completing the bridge. So the structural part was done pretty much the other day, but I had to finish putting some final screws in, deck screws, and I also sealed it up today with some clear wood sealer. So it now officially, this portion of my project is done, which is the bridge. So yeah, I just used some Thompson's wood clear water sealer and wood sealer, excuse me, for it. I know there's more expensive stuff out there to use, and you know, eventually I might try it, but for right now, for my purposes, this is good enough. So you see it's still a little wet some spots, but yeah, that is the completed bridge. So hopefully, I know this video is probably not going to give you any really good technical information, because I didn't show you every detail of the building process, just completed sections and completed segments, but it gives you an idea of what you can do with some decent plans and ideas. And yeah, and don't forget, if you have any questions, or you are interested in building something like this, you can go online to Rainbow Bridges Mathematica, I think it's called, and I'll leave you, put a little link up here to show you the website. So until next time, that's it. Thanks.
It's a fool who believes love is bread in the bone, and there's no guarantees that you won't get stoned. Yeah, I'm a fool who believes love is bread in the bone, and there's no guarantees that I won't get stoned. Susie on the bridge, you know where you get there fast. Put it in the past, put it in the past. If this is a race, then I hope you come last. You're on the bridge, you know where you get there. And the last one's gone. You dig deep just to carry on. Your debt's paid off, but it don't feel gone. So you slip out the back and you're moving on. Since you're on the bridge, you know.